Every time I make a video about depression, by the time it's uploaded and people leave their opinions, I realize more and more how sensitive of a topic it really is. I don't say that to offend anybody, but I do know by now that I have to be very careful with the words that I choose when talking about this topic. I can only speak from personal experience. Though, I am aware that there are more serious cases out there, and that is why I ask for you to take everything I say in this video with a grain of salt. As I am not a therapist, I am just a normal person making this video to help people. With that being said, I want to tell the story of how a depressed 39-year-old man went from rock bottom to becoming a hero who saves his city. The story starts with the iconic Homer Simpson working at his corporate job. As his son, Bart, visits his job thanks to a school field trip, he's not in the best position to be making a good impression. There are already rumors floating around in Bart's class that Homer is an incompetent worker, and when they meet him, he pretty much proves them right after accidentally causing a malfunction in the factory. This causes him to be fired on the spot. Not only is this sad for Homer, but it is embarrassing for his son. Once he returns home, his family help him look for a new job. But it isn't easy when he is constantly putting himself down with his discouraging choice of words.
I've never done anything worthwhile in my life. I'm a big worthless nothing.
Homer fails to realize that jobs don't defy one's self-worth. Luckily, his family is very encouraging, using positive affirmations to give him the optimism he needs to pursue whatever is out there.
You've always bounced back.
Yeah, Dad, you can do it.
Yeah, go for it, Dad.
So he looks for a new job, but is unable to find anything by the end of the day. He then goes to his quote-unquote friend to grab a drink to feel better about his situation. I say quote-unquote because his friend tells him straight into his face that he believes he will never find another job. At this point, Homer has no money, he is completely broke, and in a major state of depression. His family gives him all the motivation they can, but since he himself doesn't believe in his worth, it doesn't really do anything. He looks for alcohol to cure his pain, but obviously that won't do him any favors. In those moments where we are depressed, we often forget that our unhealthy addictions ultimately make the depression worse. We then try to justify their existence by claiming they serve as temporary ways to ease the pain. But the truth remains that our unhealthy addictions don't ease the pain long term, and they never will. As we continue with the story, Homer becomes so desperate for money that he breaks his son's piggy bank, immediately feeling a tremendous amount of guilt for doing so.
A few measly cents, not even enough to buy one beer.
He has completely fallen victim to the illusions of society's standards.
I need money!
If you are watching this and are currently in a similar situation to Homer, know that your worth isn't defined by how much money you make or what kind of job you have. You could have the crappiest job in the world, but still be worthy of great success. It all depends on the story you tell yourself. The story that Homer tells himself and the story that he writes to his family in his final letter to them is that he is an utter failure, and everyone would be better off without him. I think you can guess what happens next, but first, I want to mention something interesting. In this letter, he writes down a few motivational phrases for his family, despite the fact that he's already given up on life.
Stand tall, have courage, and never give up.
This implies that, deep down, Homer knows the right thing to do, and the advice he needs to hear. I feel like the same can apply to many of us who are currently struggling with depression. That's why I asked the question, if someone were to give you advice, what would you want that person to tell you? Perhaps write it down. Say it out loud to yourself a couple of times. there is a possibility that you already have the answers that you're looking for and might not even realize it. I'm not saying don't seek help, but I do want to mention that it is possible to motivate yourself to never give up. Of course, Homer goes through with this plan to, you know what, but I just had to ask myself the question, why would he still go through with it if he already knows he shouldn't? There is no way I can come up with a definitive answer, but I can say without a doubt that depression is no joke. You see, this type of depression is more serious than being sad all the time, or feeling like the world is too hard to handle, or whatever it is that people simplify depression into. This kind of depression is being done with life entirely. You see no point in continuing the journey. You're not even sad anymore. You're not frustrated. You're not feeling like a victim. You're just done. Done with it all. And when you reach a point like that, it's definitely a challenge to find a reason to continue because you feel like you heard all the advice there is. But I just want you to know, if you are one of those people, that it is possible to overcome even this type of depression. You just have to believe it is. I know that can feel impossible, but your mind is more powerful than you realize at the moment, and you are more important than you realize at the moment. Homer's family certainly understands his importance, and that's why, as soon as they find out what his plans are, they go on the hunt to find him. They're so focused on finding him that they fail to notice a truck heading in their direction, but luckily Homer does notice at the last minute and saves them all. His family tell him how much they love him and would have been saddened if he did decide to go through with his intentions.
We love you.
Yeah, Dad, yeah. We love you.
I find it crazy how we can see that Homer's family has given him so much love and support despite him being jobless. And it takes him all the way up until his darkest moment to become aware of this. This same oversight can apply to real life people who believe that they are not loved by anyone. This is going to be kind of hard for me to explain, but there are various different forms of love that exist in this world. Many times, we become so focused on one specific type of love, whether that be romantic love, love for money, friendship love, you get the idea. But the reality is that love is all around us, whether we want to realize it or not. If you are someone who has the belief that you are not loved, know that there is someone or something that does love you always. If Homer would have realized this sooner, he would have understood sooner that his family's love for him is and will always be more important than how much money he makes. In a strange way, saving his family gives Homer the motivation he needs to continue living life. Feeling pissed off about there not being a stop sign that would have prevented any chance of a tragedy from happening, he finds a purpose, a mission, to be that person who actually cares enough to do something about the street signs in the city he lives in. Long story short, Homer goes on to become the hero of his city and gains an incredible amount of respect by the citizens. Doing something meaningful for people is what helped Homer feel good about himself again. Humans are like that. We like to help one another. That's why when we do so without expecting anything in return, it makes us feel good inside. It can be one of the best ways to cure a depressive state, believe it or not. A lot of times, we feel like we're the ones that need the help, so why not be the help for someone else? The help that we wish someone would be for us. But that can only happen if we believe we have something valuable to provide to the world. Now, I could be here all day giving motivation, but at the end of the day, it all starts and ends with you, the viewer. Once you finally realize and step into your own power and capabilities, I can't make you believe in yourself. I can't make you take action to go after your dreams. I can't make you do anything. You have to do that for yourself. The power is not in this video. The power is in you. When you decide enough is enough with living a mediocre life and realize you deserve better and you can create better than what already exists. So, I encourage you to be the hero of your own story. In the words of the hero from this story, there is a little Homer Simpson inside all of us.